This is an ABC News special report. Now reporting, George Stephanopoulos.
And we are back on the air right now because we have just learned that President Trump has put out a tweet announcing that he has a new Secretary of State. Mike Pompeo, the CIA director, is in. Rex Tillerson, the current Secretary of State, is out. It has been a fractious relationship for some time. Remember those reports last summer that Rex Tillerson, the Secretary of State, called President Trump a moron? He was on thin ice then. The relationship did not improve much. Just recently, just this week, he was blindsided on a trip to Africa when President Trump announced that he was going to have a summit meeting with the leader of North Korea, Kim Jong-un, at a time when the Secretary of State was saying it was not time for the talk. So I'm here with my colleague this morning here on GMA, Cecilia Vega, also senior White House correspondent. This has been a difficult relationship.
From the start, George, and I'm just speaking with White House officials who tell me that this departure is not related to one issue in particular. You mentioned that moron comment. Tillerson never admitted that he said that directly, but certainly that played a role in this for this president. This departure comes as the Secretary of State is in Africa, had to cut that trip short. Now, I'm told by the people that I'm talking to in the White House that the president had asked the Secretary of State for his resignation on Friday, and that this is because the president wanted to get his team in place with CIA Director Mike Pompeo at the helm to start these conversations with North Korea about that meeting between the president and Kim Jong-un, as well as these conversations about trade that are happening at a very international, global level. So this is not one thing that I'm told by the White House that this felt like the right time for President Trump.
Right. It was not a good fit between the two gentlemen. Also, the president announcing that Gina Haspel, a career CIA officer who he appointed as deputy director of the CIA, will replace Mike Pompeo at the head of the Central Intelligence Agency. I believe we now have on the phone Martha Raddatz, our chief diplomatic. I'm afraid we do not have Martha right now, but we do have John Carl at the White House. And John, this comes as the entire White House national security team has to be coming together to figure out what to do about that summit meeting with Kim Jong-un.
Absolutely. A decision by the president to accept that invitation to meet with Kim Jong-un that surprised the national security team, including, as Cecilia pointed out, Tillerson himself. So they'll need to get Pompeo in place. I'm sure he will move in as the acting Secretary of State. But it comes at a time when there is nobody there as a point person on Korea. The person that had that job resigned just last month. We have no ambassador in South Korea. So a lot of upheaval on the national security team, particularly at the State Department, which, as you know, is the agency that is the point on diplomacy. So this is the ultimate diplomatic effort. And now we have a turnover at the top.
But John, the president does have a close relationship with Pompeo, and some say his favorite member of the cabinet.
He has a very close relationship with Pompeo. Pompeo, as the CIA director, was here most mornings when the president would get his presidential daily brief. In fact, he spent a lot of time here at the White House. Some career CIA people would joke that he spent more time here at the White House than he did actually out at Langley at CIA headquarters. But the bottom line is he has a very close relationship with the president. The president feels comfortable with him and undoubtedly would feel comfortable with him in this major diplomatic effort, by far the most significant diplomatic effort that the president has made so far.
Cecilia Vega, the president did it his way. I think this has got to be the first time in history we've heard about a new Secretary of State by a tweet.
Yeah, certainly that. And let's just remind our audience that this comes amid this complete turmoil in the White House. The president has said there is no chaos, that everything is running as smoothly, but this adds to a long list of departures. Hope Hicks, Gary Cohn within the last few weeks, and now no Secretary of State being replaced by a CIA director. We are back in an issue of turmoil for this White
More
House
More than 30 top officials in the last year, just 14 months into this administration. We're going to get back to our regular programming right now. In some parts of the country, of course, that is GMA, and we'll have a complete wrap-up tonight on World News Tonight with David Muir. You can get the latest anytime on abcnews.com. Have a good day.
This has been a special report from ABC News.
Hi, everyone. George Stephanopoulos here. Thanks for checking out the ABC News YouTube channel. If you'd like to get more videos, show highlights, and watch live event coverage, click on the right over here to subscribe to our channel. And don't forget to download the ABC News app for breaking news alerts. Thanks for watching.